Hello, and welcome back to California Geology. I am Dr. Robert Lopez, and today I want to do the last segment of my lecture series here for plate tectonics, covering hotspots and why plates move. Now, hotspots are really a surface manifestation of a mantle plume, and usually at hotspots you're going to find volcanoes, right? You'll have volcanoes. Hawaii is a hotspot. Yellowstone is a hot spot. Samoa is a hot spot. And geologists still are not quite sure how hot spots form. We know they're not related to, well, they're not always at plate boundaries. They could be far away from plate boundaries. Some, like the Galapagos Island and Iceland, coincide with like divergent margins, but many of them are not related to plate tectonic boundaries. So they're kind of unusual. And they really come from a thing called a mantle plume. And a mantle plume is a flux of heat. So maybe a movement of heat from possibly the core mantle boundary or maybe the transition layer somewhere within the mantle where this flux of heat, this movement occurs like in a pipe. So it's a singular pipe moving up through the mantle and it travels a stationary path. And when it reaches the surface, it's going to make volcanoes, right? For example, the Hawaiian Islands formed as a hot spot. And so here, note that the hot spot, the mantle plume comes up here. It produces the volcanoes. And as the tectonic plate moves, like this volcano that's active right now, eventually as the plate keeps moving, it'll be carried away from the hot spot, right? And so these are called aseismic ridges. For example, all these volcanoes are older. They were once at the hotspot and have since been carried away. And they're not active, so they're without seismicity. Now, looking at this map of the Hawaiian Islands, we see that the current position of the hotspot is down at the Big Island, Hawaii. And we see that Maui and Molokai, the ages get older and older. Kauai up to about 5.6 million years old, right? So the farther the volcano is from the hotspot, the older it is, because Kauai at some point, 5 million years ago, it was at the hotspot, right? So that's the how these hotspots work. And so, in fact, in the Pacific Ocean, what we'll look at here, we see the position of the Hawaiian Islands. In fact, there's a seamount called Lauihi, which will be the next Hawaiian island, because Hawaii is already moving away from the hotspot, right? But you can see this whole aseismic ridge called the Hawaiian Ridge. The ages get older and older and older as you go farther away. And even the Emperor Seamount chain is part of that same series of aseismic ridges that formed at this hotspot. In essence, these volcanoes, these seamounts and geos are documenting the path of the Pacific plate over that hotspot. Now, the next thing I want to talk about here, or the last thing, will be what causes tectonic plates to move? And your book actually mentions these three terms. Well, there's convection in the mantle. Convection is a circular transport of heat. This is a circular transport. A circular transport. And this transport may lead to movement of the asthenosphere, right? So causes asthenosphere to flow. Remember, I mentioned that the asthenosphere can flow. Fear to flow. And when it flows, it's going to cause tectonic plates to move. Now, going back over here, we see that here's some convection cells. A couple of models. One suggests that the entire mantle is convecting, where heat rises at divergent margins. As it moves away, it cools and will descend back into the mantle at these convergent margins, right? So that's a convection, right? And then for the ridge push, right? Remember these, because the heat causes a thermal buoyancy and the mid-oceanic ridge is high above the seafloor. Some of these ridges are anywhere from 10 to 12,000 feet above the seafloor. So there is a gradient, a gravity is pushing down. So that's a ridge push. So you can see a push from the ridge that allows this to slide upon the slippery asthenosphere down here, right? And then finally, as the tectonic plate gets older, this ocean lithosphere gets older and older, it'll subduct into the ocean trench, right? And because it's heavy and old, it's going to be pulling. So there's, again, force of gravity pulling here, pulling this ocean lithosphere back into the trench. So anyhow, why plates move? Mantle convection, probably the main one, causes the asthenosphere to flow, which means the tectonic plates are going to move. And then there's a ridge push from the mid-oceanic ridge and the slab pull, which is the pull of this ocean subducting lithosphere. Well, let's stop here and we'll see you for minerals.